The Derby Owners Club, it rocks.
It's the sport of kings, one of humankind's most ancient forms of competition dating back to 4500 BC. It's enjoyed by hundreds of millions of spectators the world over, and now it's available for your location. Introducing Derby Owners Club World Edition. Derby Owners Club World Edition is a role-playing game in which players are thoroughbred racehorse breeders, trainers, jockeys, and owners. How many video games do you own that encourage players to take a piece home with them every time they play? That's exactly what Derby Owners Club World Edition does. Utilizing Sega's exclusive memory card reader and dispenser technology, players take their horse with them on a convenient credit card-sized storage device.
Take the card with you.
They can use their Derby Owners Club card to race their horse in any Derby Owners Club World Edition game in the country.
I love to play this game so much that I almost have 30 cards.
A typical racing sequence can last anywhere from 6 to 10 minutes, depending upon the proficiency of the player, whether he or she is creating a new horse or using a previously created one. Each race is made up of a field of 12 horses. Up to 8 live racers, actual players, can compete with a minimum of 4 Virtua or computer-controlled thoroughbreds. But before you can hit the track, you must create your horse. Choose the parents. Play starts by visiting the breeding farm to select your sire and dam. Name your horse. Once your horse is foaled, you can name it with up to 18 characters. Each horse is born with his or her own unique capabilities, likes, and dislikes. Your horse's capabilities are indicated in the box at the top left portion of your screen. These include starting. How fast can your horse get out of the gate? Cornering. How well will your horse perform in the corners? Out of the box. When in traffic, will your horse remain timidly behind the field, or will it look for a seam and charge out of the box? Competing. Is your horse able to stand up to bigger, stronger horses, or will he or she back down when challenged? Tenacity. As the race nears the end, will your horse finish tough or fade away? Spurt. How much will your horse jump ahead when you go to the whip?
Go, baby, go!
Players control their horses using 2 primary buttons, hold to slow the horse down, and whip to speed the horse up.
I get a real kick out of it. There's a lot of reality based on the game.
Every time you play, you begin with the pre-race routines of training and feeding your racehorse. Training consists of a variety of workout regimens. In solo training, you train against the clock. You must finish your training run in exactly the time indicated, no slower and no faster. You train against another horse in cooperative training. Here, you must finish your training run in a dead heat, not after or before the other horse. Solo pool training. In this mode, you learn to keep your horse's head above water. Even racehorses get tired. That's why there's rest mode. Giving your horse a break at the right time will invigorate him or her for the next series of races. After training, your thoroughbred is going to be hungry. Pick a food that improves your horse's abilities. Of course, no two horses are created equal. Each horse has its own set of likes and dislikes, so don't be surprised if your horse doesn't like a particular training regimen or food. How will you know? Trust us, your horse will make it known in no uncertain terms what he or she does not like.
Horses are on the track.
Once you're off to the races, players are assigned a random gate assignment ranging from number 1 to number 12. As the horses appear on the main display, their ability chart, lifetime earnings, and win-loss record is shown.
One more time.
During the race, the player satellite displays provide a wide array of telemetry. Your horse's health is indicated on the screen with a bar. If you don't use proper whip technique, the bar will move to the right, indicating your horse is extremely tired and won't have any energy left to finish the race. A meter counts down the distance to the finish line. It's important to know how far your horse has left to race, so you'll know when to go to the whip. Your horse has a limited number of races during which he or she will be competitive. How many races depends on the quality of its bloodlines and the effectiveness of your training and feeding regimens. When you retire your horse, it enters a new phase in its life cycle. You can then use your retired thoroughbred as the sire or dam of future champions.
These are the horses that I own, and I have a couple of favorites that I had to retire, unfortunately, and I'm waiting to get one of the special horses. One more
time. Sega has entered into an agreement with the National Thoroughbred Racing Association designating Derby Owners Club World Edition as the official branded interactive video game of NTRA. NTRA plans on using Derby Owners Club to host player tournaments and product demonstrations at racetrack and offsite venues, in connection with summer and fall stakes races that are part of NTRA's Road to the World Thoroughbred Championships. NTRA will host a special chat room for Derby Owners Club players on its website, ntra.com. Very few games have ever been developed that create the kind of long-term earnings, player loyalty, and ancillary location benefits that Derby Owners Club World Edition delivers. It's a phenomenon that's poised to sweep across the country. Get caught up in it before it passes you by.
Go, baby, go!
I play like probably 3 times, 4 times a week.
You know, you're competing against other people. It doesn't get boring.
The Derby Owners Club is very fun.
Derby Owners Club is the bomb, man.
I'd love to have one of these in my home, so can I get one?
Lord,